of earthquake. Earthquake can happen not only due to the tectonic plate movement, also due to volcanic earthquake can happen. So the volcanic type earthquake will not occur in all the places. The volcanoes are active at certain parts in world. Wherever you have active volcanoes, in those parts you will be experiencing an earthquake. When the volcano is getting busted in some area, during the burst, the earth shakes. So this is another form of the earthquake. India doesn't have any active volcanoes and it is the safest place. Only due to tectonic movement, the earthquake can happen. In islands, number of islands, you will be experiencing active volcanoes. This volcanic earthquakes are much lesser in magnitude. Next one is collapse. Collapse might happen due to mining. When you are mining the minerals, how the minerals are being mined is by detonating. So you have to explore the rocks below the earth or the surface. When you want to make tunnel, you are going to explode. The adjacent soil gets disturbed and it makes a small vibration and the waves are getting generated. This is much smaller than volcanic earthquake. Last type is explosion. Explosion is due to man-made. The earthquakes are natural made. That is, tectonic earthquake is natural. Volcanic earthquake is also natural. But this collapse and explosion, if you are making tunneling, then that is a collapsible mode and mining is for man-made purpose. Explosion will also be there due to any war field. Nuclear explosion might be there. So due to that explosion, what happens? The earthquake might occur. There are further classification of earthquake based on location. One is interplate and another one is intraplate. When the earthquake is occurring between the joint of the fault, then it is called interplate earthquake, and intraplate earthquake is in between fault. Next one, based on epicentral distance. If it is below 100 km, then it is local earthquake. And if the earthquake occurs between 100 to 1000 km, then it is called regional earthquake. And teleseismic earthquake are greater than 1000 km. Based on focal depth, you can see 0 to 71 km, and intermediate depth is 71 to 300 km. Deeper earthquake is greater than 300 km. So there is a difference between focal depth and epicenter. This is focal depth and epicentral. This is epicentral distance. This is the two difference. If the earthquake is occurring below the ground, and this is the focal depth. So according to the depth, it is being considered as some earthquake. What do you mean by epicentral distance is, if it can cross more than 1000 kilometers in distance, then it is called epicenter. Focal depth, you can understand based on these types. Yes, by this example you can understand. See, some earthquake location. So if it is a station, the station indicates a seismometric station. If the seismometer is installed here and an earthquake is being observed till 1800 kilometers, then it is called teleseismic earthquake. So according to this case, you can see teleseismic earthquakes are greater than 1000 kilometers. And you are having another station here, TEIG. These are all seismic station and they will record all the earthquake motions, analyze, monitor and develop the statistics. How to locate an earthquake? You can see three number of instruments are being installed. All the three instruments will measure the same earthquake. And nobody can physically go and visit the focal depth where the earthquake is occurred. We cannot physically view it, and even though it is below the earth, how we can understand their terminology and characteristic is by installing these instruments. One instrument will say that the earthquake occurred at 1800 kilometer distance, and this instrument identifies that an earthquake occurred at 900 kilometer distance. And third one, so by this minimum three number of instrument, you can able to locate. So at what time it would have started, it reached the station point. So based on epicentral is what we have understood currently. Based on focal depth, how much depth the earthquake occurred is based on these three. Based on magnitude, you have micro earthquake, dogs, they can send, and intermediate earthquake is around 3 to 4.9. This can be observed slightly in the building and by the human. Moderate earthquakes are 5 to 5.9, strong earthquake 6 to 6.9. This strong earthquake makes the property damage. And above that, if the earthquake is occurring, it does not make much property damage and life loss. From the strong earthquake, we are very much interested. So how to tackle this strong earthquake? Around 180 number of earthquake is occurring throughout the world, continuously year by year. But we are still suffering due to that. Major earthquake 7 to 7.9 and finally great earthquake. What do you mean by great earthquake is, if it is more than Richter scale of 8, it is called great earthquake, where the majority of the structure gets collapsed. And if we are preparing for great earthquake, there is too much of amount has to be spent to make the construction. In India, Bhuj, the state of Gujarat, you have a hospital which is being constructed by elastomeric bearing. The total hospital is completely covered with bearings. There will be a set of rubber pads and they are known as elastomers. So these elastomers, what will happen? They will be like a sandwich. The whole column will be not connected to the earth. There will be a sandwich layer, and during an earthquake, what happens? This layer tries to deflect in whatever mode the earthquake is occurring. And the hospital can withstand up to Richter 8, that is the great earthquake. During any cause in future, after the Bhuj earthquake happened, the government take an initiation safety against the earthquake. So soon after the earthquake, you need a hospital in order to run successfully, in order to cure the patients during the devastating earthquake. So at least in a state, there should be a single construction like this. Whatever might be the earthquake, the structure like hospital, telecommunication center and monuments, so we should take care about all the structures. See, when you are speaking about monuments, it only speaks about civil engineer. So civil engineer plays a vital role. There is a fault rupture here. So this is the point of focus. The waves are only generated, and in between particles, in between the soil, the waves are being transferred and it strikes to the structure. There are two types of waves. One is body wave and another one is surface wave. You can understand this is the earth crust and this is the earth surface. When the waves are traveling in the surface, this is called surface waves. When the waves are traveling below the crust, it is known as body wave, and in the surface it is called surface wave. So these are the two types of wave they have split. If you are digging deep, you can see a confined aquifer might be there, and there might be some different types of soil in between certain area. So when the seismic wave is passing through the soil, what happens? Certain waves will not pass through it. The S wave in particular, it does not travel through the sea. What a seismic wave generally is, large strain energy released during an earthquake travels as seismic wave. What are these waves? These waves are strain energy which is being released. When you clap your hands, you can observe some vibration in between your palms and hands. So this vibration is called strain energy. When you clap hands, muscles will be contracted and expanded. The similar way, the vibration experience in an earthquake between the two surface or the two fault zones. So when it strikes or fault or it can dip, what happens? These wave are called strain energy. It has been released, transferred. This is called a seismic wave. Waves in all the directions throughout the earth layer. the waves will transfer at all the sites. Okay, what about the rest of the waves? Is these waves will transfer into the liquid state. So you know, in an earth you will be having core, outer core, mantle, and then you have the crust. The waves which go into the earth is not going to get damaged for any people, so we are not interested in it. Those waves which are striking the surface, these are all very much interested, and we want to know and study about that. Reflecting and refracting at each interface. These volcanoes erupt during the pressure. So due to earth pressure, what happens? It erupts. Similarly, in a pressure cooker, what happens? Slowly the heat gets increased. So if it is getting increased, the pressure has to release somewhere. Similarly, like that, the interior of the earth has some nuclear fission is happening. So slowly the earth is getting pressured. So in the top of the earth, you will be having the plates. So these plates, they cannot take the pressure. So somewhere or the other, they have to release the pressure. These are the places, pressure releasing points are called volcanoes, active volcanoes. So they have the knob in order to release the energy. So what are the energies there below the earth surface? Is mantle. You can see the volcano. So after the release of the energy, it automatically gets cooled. In a certain period of time, it again happens. Nature will be as it is. So you have to understand the nature, how it behaves, and you have to monitor the nature and live accordingly. So living according to nature is the best thing for a human. Earthquake is also similar to that. You should know where the earthquake is occurring, how frequently it is occurring, and how it is devastating. You have to understand types of seismic wave. There are two types. One is body wave and surface wave, which I have said, these are all called body waves, and in the surface where the waves are transmitted are called surface waves. Body waves are consist of two types. One is primary wave and another one is secondary wave. It might be called P wave and S wave in short. Surface wave consists of Love wave and Rayleigh wave. Professor Love, who identified the different character of the wave. And next thing is Rayleigh wave. He is Professor Rayleigh, and he identified certain characteristics in an earthquake. So it is generally called as Rayleigh wave. Okay. When we are understanding characteristic of wave, first wave is called P wave. What do you mean by that? Is primary wave. You can understand fault number one, fault number two. It is getting sheared, and if it is sheared, what happens? From the focus, the earthquake is getting generated and it is being transferred in all the directions. So when it is being transferred, you can see this fault area. This is the fault area and this is the focus. When the wave is traveling, it will travel in form of push and pull. So from the starting of the focus, it waves, it transfers in this manner. So it is the fastest wave in the four waves. Primary waves are the fastest wave. When an earthquake is going to occur, if you are in a building, if your building is pushing and pulling, then you should understand that there is a severity and there is an earthquake is going to get happen. Soon you have to act accordingly. And it travels at a speed of 4.8 km per second. So it is unimaginable, and it is more than sound. So it travels more quickly than sound. When they travel through air, they take the form of sound waves. The particle generally goes under extensional and compressional strains. So it extends and compresses. So this is the character of P wave. Then next wave is called S wave. S wave is generally a wave which is moving up and down. Its velocity is less than primary wave. So S wave has a velocity of around 3 km per second. They do not travel through liquids. So if there is any liquid part, if the wave is traveling and any confined aquifer is there, what happens? It travels through the confined aquifer. It travels in up and down mode. When it matches the confined aquifer, the liquid collapses the wave, and after the aquifer, it cannot pass through it. So certain waves are sent back. This is the direction of transmission S wave goes through up and down motion. Third type wave is called Love wave. When a horizontal wave, primary wave is pushing and pulling, so it is compression and tension. So secondary wave is going up and down, so the wave will go up and down. So the Love wave goes in horizontal direction. If the wave is going in horizontal zigzag mode, that is in sideways, this is the best example. If the wave is going in sideways, then it is called a Love wave. It does not have vertical component, it only have horizontal component. And S wave associated with Love wave causes maximum damage. What is S wave? The movement of up and down. And what is Love wave? Horizontal direction. If both are combined, what will happen? The building will move up and down also in sideways. So you will not be getting better clarity what is happening around. The secondary wave, it will not give you a proper vision. That is why you can see all the vehicles are being stopped. So you want to go in certain direction, but you cannot pass in certain direction. Why? Because your vision and your foot will not ground properly. Now the three types of waves are over. Finally, the fourth type of wave will come. It is called Rayleigh wave, called a elliptical wave. It does not travel horizontally or vertically. It travels in rotative mode or in elliptical direction. This Rayleigh wave make a particle to oscillate in elliptical path in vertical plane, not in horizontal, in vertical plane. Shaking is more severe at earth surface. If you are constructing any structure below the earth surface, acceleration below the ground will be much lesser. If you construct above the earth, then the acceleration will be twice than the surface of the